This is a very interesting and unusual bicycle.
It's a BSA spring frame. The spring frame is the most sought after BSA, and it was supplied as what they called a BSA fittings bicycle. BSA didn't make their own bicycles until 1909. So they supplied bicycles like these in knockdown form, and small manufacturers could build them themselves, either using their own frames with BSA components, the BSA fittings, or in this case, BSA's own frame, the spring frame, assembled by individual companies. This particular company was called Haviland Richard and Co., and they operated from Small Heath in Birmingham, which is obviously near BSA's own factory. They called this model the Victoria, and the transfer still exists on the down tube of the frame of the bicycle. After Queen Victoria's death, of course, in 1901, there was a surge of products named the Victoria. You'll see various sprung components on this bicycle. Behind the headlock, at the front of the top tube, is a pivot. And then there's a coil spring in the middle of the top tube, just under the front of the saddle. The rear stays have twin, what we might call shock absorbers now. And then in the centre of the chain wheel, the bottom bracket, you can see two hinge joints. So this allowed the bicycle to be sprung at the front and the back. Fortunately, it is a bit of a design fault because the rear section springs independently of the front section, but the mudguard isn't sprung. So, if you look very closely, there are a couple cracks in the mudguard at the back. Nowhere to take up the tension. I suppose it should have a sprung rear mudguard. The bicycle itself has its original BSA transfer on the seat tube, which BSA allowed to be featured if they built the frame. And this bicycle has a BSA saddle and a BSA inflator pump. A new departure coaster hub is fitted, as well as a front brake. BSA was one of this country's most important cycle manufacturers. They started out as gun makers and through government contracts supplying arms and ammunition and bicycles too for the military, helped defend the British Empire through the Boer War as well as two World Wars. The factory was actually opened in 1862. They were an amalgamation of various small engineering firms, becoming the Birmingham Small Arms Company. Government orders absorbed nearly all their energies to start with, and the first order from the government was for Enfield muzzle loading rifles. Following that, they made the Snider rifle, which was the first breech loading rifle used in this country, and subsequently the Martini Henry rifle, and in 1888 the Lee Metford bolt action magazine rifle. The first bike they made in any quantity was called the Otto. It had wheels side by side. And they continued to make bikes and trikes until 1887, when government demand for rifles and ammunition meant they had to suspend cycle production. By 1893, government demand declined for the rifles and ammunition, and once more they started making bikes. In early 1893, they made safety bike hubs, which were exhibited at the Crystal Palace show that year. A little later, they introduced brackets, cranks, steering heads, seat lugs, chain wheels, fork and stay ends, pedals, and at the Crystal Palace show of 1894, exhibited their first complete set of BSA cycle fittings. What this meant was that a manufacturer could buy a complete bicycle full of components and make their own frame. And the standard of these components, the BSA fittings, were such that they were made to the same standard as BSA's rifles, i.e. consistent in design and standard. So many bicycle manufacturers started up themselves by making their own frames and using BSA parts. In 1900, the turn of the century, the BSA company introduced their first freewheel clutch and backpedaling rim brake. They were very popular. The following year, they introduced a front pull-up rim brake. You can see one on this bicycle. And BSA mudguards and stays were first made in 1901-2. In 1902, they supplied fittings for path racers, light roadsters, full roadsters and ladies machines. And 1902 saw the introduction of the standard pattern spring frame, which was supplied to the trade complete. The BSA spring frame was actually one of the most successful ever put on the market, and many were still in use several decades later. 1902 was also an eventful one for BSA, because that's the year where the War Office adopted BSA fittings for military bicycles, and the majority of bicycles used by the War Office from that time onward were built of BSA fittings.